Okay, so residue can be find out as you know when we do partial fraction how to find it out. So if we are considering this particular residue, then we'll take as a S minus P1, or if I can say PI, okay, for different poles. F of S for replacing value of S with PI. Okay. If I want to find out residue KI, then I can by graphical method, then I can write it as a H into product of phasors in polar form, right? From each 0 to pi, means that particular pole, upon product of phasors in polar form from other poles to pi. Okay, and steps to solve this particular example are like this. First step, you will get it understood when I will solve numerical, don't worry. So first step will be draw pole zero diagram for given function. Second step, measure distance from each other pole to the given pole. Okay, we have to measure the distance from all other poles to the considered pole. Then third is measure, say on similar note, measure distance from each of other zeros to the given pole. Okay, similarly as we have measured from all other poles, similarly we will measure from all other zeros too. Okay, next step is we have to measure the angle. Measure angle from each other pole to the given pole. And fifth, measure angle from each other zeros to given pole, right? And last step is substitute these values in the required residue equation. You have to substitute all these values in a required residue equation. Now, I know this fine bit difficult to understand, so we'll solve one numerical and we'll understand how to implement it. So first I will consider a very simple example. This is a pole zero plot. Rather, I will consider first example, that is I of S is given as a 2S upon S plus 1 by S plus 2. And what has been asked? Plot the pole zero pattern in the S plane and find I of T. Okay? So first two questions are there. First question to find pole zero plot of the given function, and then we will have to find out I of t, means in time domain, for which we will have to find out residue, and then we will take a Laplace inverse. So before that, let's see. I will have a pole zero plot. We can see it is having 0 at, obviously 0, no? 2 of s equal to 0, so s is 0. So 1, 0 will be here. Okay. Similarly, where will be the poles? S plus 1 equal to 0, so s equal to minus 1. So at minus 1 we will have one pole, and s plus 2 equal to 0, so s equal to minus 2, means another pole will be here, right? Minus 1 and minus 2. So if you remember our steps, first step was draw the pole zero diagram of the given network function, and we have completed first step. Now second step, measure the distance from each of the other pole to given pole. Okay, measure the distance from each of the other pole to the given pole. Okay, which is given pole? For that we have to consider a partial fraction. Let's come here. Okay, we are having I of S equal to, by partial fraction I can write as a k1 upon s plus 1 plus k2 upon s plus 2. Now we are having formula k1 equal to h into phasors or product of phasors from 0 to pole. Now when I say k1, right, then we are considering pole, we will name it as A and we will name it as a B. Okay, so when I consider pole A, then it is a k1, right? So phasor from 0, which is only 1, to pole at A. Similarly, phasor from pole means when we are considering this particular pole, we have to take phasor from all other poles and zeros to it, and zeros will be considered in numerator and poles will be considered in a denominator. Okay, when I will consider k2, that is for B, then I will take phasor from 0 to B in numerator and phasor from A to B in denominator. Now the important thing is, what is h? H is given as a 2, so I will take 2 as it is. Phasor from 0 to pole at A, phasor from 0 means from here I will take phasor, and what is the magnitude of this phasor? 1, so I will take 1, right? Magnitude is a 1, 0 to 1. And what is angle? Because our fourth step was to measure the angle. What is the angle from x axis? We can see it is 180 degrees. So 1 at an angle 180 degrees. So this is in the numerator. Now what is the denominator? Phasor from another pole to the considered pole. So this is distance. Now distance between these two poles, don't get confused, don't measure from here. Now we are dealing with this point. Okay, so what is 2 minus 1? 1, and we are going to take magnitude only. Okay, so 1, distance is 1. What is angle? Obviously 0. So I can write it down as a 0 degree, and it will become as a 2 at an angle 180 degree, so minus 2, right? Now we will find out k2. We are finding residue, right? So again h, and now here I can say phasor from 0 to pole at B now. Okay, similarly for phasor from pole to the pole at B. Okay, in numerator we will consider zeros, in denominator we will consider pole. Now again h is a 2. For here, now see, from 0 I have to take a phasor. What is the distance from 0 to 2? That is a 2. So I can write on 2. What is the angle? Again 180 degrees. I can write 180 degrees. Similarly, now distance from this pole to this pole, A to B. So again magnitude is 1 and angle is, now it is moving from here. So angle is here, also angle is 180 degrees. So I can write it down 1 at an angle 180 degrees. So if you solve it, you will get 2 into 2, 180 degrees, angle will get cancelled and it will become 4. Okay. Now I of S I can write as I of S equal to this is minus 2, no, right? Y's 2 equal to minus 2, that is a by partial fraction, minus 2 upon s plus 1 plus 4 upon s plus 2. This is I of S. But what has been asked? It has been asked to find I of T. Okay, so this is frequency domain means Laplace transform, no? So to find out time domain, we have to take its inverse Laplace. So taking inverse Laplace transform. Secondly, it is I of t equal to inverse of it will be minus 2, and for 1 upon h plus 1 is a Laplace of e raised to that part, this particular value. So I can write down as a 2 e raised to minus t. Okay, if it is plus, here it will be minus. If it is minus, here it will be plus. Plus 4 e raised to minus 2t. Right? So this is the I of t. This is how we have to solve the example. Now we will solve one more example, which is in a different context. Let's see. In previous example, we saw that poles and zeros, everything was on a sigma axis, real axis. Now we will consider one condition where they are not like that. It is in the nature of sigma n plus j omega n t. Okay. So I am having voltage V of S as 3s upon s plus 2 s square plus 2s plus 2. Okay. So here first of all I have to find out roots of denominator, right? So roots of denominator will be 3 of s upon s plus 2, and here I have to expand the middle term and I will get roots as a s plus 1 plus j1 s plus 1 minus j1. Okay, I have got roots. Now let's have a pole zero plot. Zero is at 0, pole, one pole at minus 2, 1, 2, one pole at minus 2, and another pole is at s plus 1 plus j, means minus 1 minus j minus 1 plus j. So minus 1 plus j here and minus 1 minus j here, if this is a j1. Now concentrate carefully, it is a complicated example. Now by partial fraction I can write V of S as k1 upon s plus 2 plus k2 upon s plus 1 minus j1 and k2 conjugate, right? No, because it is a conjugate. So k2 upon s plus 1 plus j1. So if I find k, this k2, value of this will be same. Okay. Now see, it is very important. You have to first write out the formula k1 equal to h into phasor from zeros to the pole, then phasors from poles to the pole. Okay. And now as we know it, we will directly try to solve it. What is scale factor h? It is 3. I have written 3. Now in numerator, which particular case I am considering? I will first name it. This is a, because s minus 2, no? So a. Second is minus 1 plus j, means this. So this is b and this is c. So I am trying to find out for this. So first we will take phasor from 0 to this point. So magnitude will be 2, obviously. 2, and angle will be 180. So 2 at an angle 180 degree. Upon, we have to consider product of the phasors from another poles to it. Means first we have to take phasor like this. We have to take its magnitude and angle, then we will take from here. So before that, what will be magnitude of this phasor? Let's see. This is 1, this is 1. So by Pythagoras, it will be, this will be under root 2, right? No, a square plus y square, a square plus b square is equal to this c square. So 1 plus 1, 2, under root of it is root 2. So phasor is root 2, and what will be angle? Either you can measure negative like this, or you can measure positive like this. So you know that magnitude of this and this is same. It means this angle is 45 degree, right? So 90 plus 45, so it will be 135. Or else you can measure from here also, and here also you have to take minus sign. So I will write it down as a 2 at an root 2, magnitude root 2, at an angle minus 135 degree. Okay, multiply by, now I will take phasor from this particular, means from all poles we have to take, no? Remember the formula. So I will take phasor from here. So again, this is one. So value, magnitude of this will be root 2. And what is the angle? Plus 135. So root 2 at an angle plus 135 degree. Okay. So if you solve it, you will get value at as a 3 under root 180 degree. So which is nothing but minus 3. Okay, it will be 3 at an angle 180 degree, sorry, by mistake. Now K2, how to find K2? For K2 means we have to consider B. So first take phasor from 0 to B. Okay, remember, 0 to B. So what will be magnitude of it? 1, 1. So this will be root 2. And what will be angle? 90 plus 45, so 135. I hope you are getting it. Root 2 at an angle 135 degree. Divide by, now for particular B, I will take from poles. So when I will take phasor from here, it is already having value root 2. And what is the angle now? Okay, this is the twist. Where to measure angle? We have to measure angle to x axis, not here. Okay, we are reaching here at B. Phasor is like this. Arrow tip is like this. So angle is 45. I can write as a root 2 at an angle 45 degree. Root 2, sorry. And we have to take phasor from this to this point. So like this. For this phasor, magnitude is 1 plus 1, 2 and angle is 90. 2 at an angle 90 degree. Now solve it and you will get value as a 3 by 2. Now one can solve for C also, K3, on similar note, means K3 equal to 3, then from 0 to here, means OC. And from poles to there. But though you solve, you will get same value. So no need to solve even in an examination. Okay, you can directly write it is 3 by 2 until and unless it is real. Now, I have to write the equation of V of S. V of S equal to minus 3 upon S plus 2 plus 3 by 2 upon S plus 1 minus J1 plus 3 by 2 upon S plus 1 plus J1. Okay, you have to take inverse Laplace of this. You can solve it actually. What you can do here, you can take 3 by 2 common and in root it will become e raised to this is plus, no, minus 1 plus j t e raised to minus 1 minus j1 t. Okay, which you can again solve, or else I will solve it. Don't worry, I will solve it. For this particular case, this particular case, I can write it as a minus 3 magnitude a raised to minus 2t. And for this two case, I can take 3 by 2 as a common, 3 by 2 in bracket, I can write as a e raised to minus 1 plus j1t plus e raised to minus 1 minus j1t. Okay. Now, I can write as a minus 3 a raised to minus 2t plus, I will adjust the term 2, okay. I can write as 2 into 3 by 2 e raised to minus t, and in bracket I can write as e raised to j1 plus e raised to minus j1 divided by 2. I have adjusted 2 outside, right? Like this. And for this, then I can write down final equation as a minus 3 e raised to minus 2t plus 3 e raised to minus t cos t due to this formula. Cos t. Okay, so this is how we have find out voltage in a time domain. Okay, thank you very much.